Welcome to the online lecture series of Turbo Machines. Here is Professor Lakshman Mane. This is lecture on centrifugal compressor part 1, that is classification, construction and working of centrifugal compressor. I acknowledge my sincere thanks to the following authors and courtesy for being used these concepts to make this video session. In this session, you will be able to illustrate classification of centrifugal compressors. You will be able to explain construction and working principle of centrifugal compressor, and you will also be able to explain applications of centrifugal compressor. Let us discuss about rotary compressors. So as per this observation, rotary compressors are the turbo machines which are used when a large quantity of air is required at low pressure. In these compressors, kinetic energy of air is converted into pressure energy by using rotating element called as impeller. Classification of rotary compressors. Rotary compressors are classified into two main categories as positive displacement compressors and dynamic compressors. Positive displacement compressors are further classified as roots blower, vane type blower, screw compressor and scroll compressor. Dynamic compressors are further classified as centrifugal compressor and axial flow compressor. Dynamic compressors. Dynamic compressors are available in both axial and radial designs. They are also called as turbo compressors. Radial design compressors are called as centrifugal compressors. So radial design means here flow of air is taking place in the radial direction, means along the radius of impeller. Axial design compressors are called as axial flow compressors. So in this type compressor, air is passing along the axis of rotor. Centrifugal compressor. Centrifugal compressors are used to supply large quantity of air but at low pressure ratio. So here air is sucked at the eye of impeller. This portion is called as eye of impeller. So air from this eye is pushed towards perimeter of impeller radially, means in radial direction, by centrifugal force. In centrifugal compressor, pressure ratio is up to 4 and speed range is from 10,000 to 20,000 RPM. Similarity between centrifugal pump and centrifugal compressor. Centrifugal pump is a power consuming device and centrifugal compressor is also power consuming device. In centrifugal pump, water enters to the eye of impeller axially and leaves the blades in radial direction. While in case of centrifugal compressor, air enters to the eye of impeller axially and leaves the blade radially. In centrifugal pump, water flows from low altitude to high altitude means from low height to high height. In case of centrifugal compressor, air flows from low pressure to high pressure. Construction and working of centrifugal compressor. So here we can see an image of centrifugal compressor. Major components of centrifugal compressor are suction side, where the air is taken inside of the compressor. Impeller is a rotating part. Diffuser. The impeller is surrounded by diffuser. Volute casing, where the air is collected from the diffuser and air is coming out from discharge side. Now we will see in detail each part. Impeller. It is a disc on which radial blades are attached. So here you can see these are the blades which are attached to the disc in along the radius, means radial direction. Air enters the eye of compressor at low velocity and at atmospheric pressure. The air moves radially outwards, passing through the impeller. So this is the passage between the two blades through which air is passing. It results simultaneously in pressure rise and generation of kinetic energy. Diffuser. Impeller is surrounded by a series of guide blades mounted on a ring, which is known as diffuser. So here we can see it provides diverging passage to the air flow. It converts kinetic energy of air into pressure energy. Thus, it increases the pressure of air. Volute casing. Volute casing houses the stationary internal components as well as rotating components. Here we can observe that area of flow from the eye of impeller to the discharge pipe is gradually increasing. So, kinetic energy is converted into pressure energy. So, air is coming out of diffuser and is collected in casing and taken out of the compressor at outlet of discharge pipe. Pressure and velocity variation of air. Now to understand this, we will have the diagram. See, this is a central portion of the compressor which is called as eye, where the air is entered. It is surrounded by impeller and impeller is surrounding the diffuser. So this is a blade, one of the blade in impeller zone, and this is one of the blade in diffuser zone. Now we will have here for pressure and velocity variation. On vertical axis, pressure and velocity, and on horizontal axis, radial distance. Now, this envelope is divided into three parts or three zones. First is eye, second is for impeller, and third is for diffuser. Air enters at atmospheric pressure P01 in suction side. It reaches to pressure P1 and velocity V1. Now, air enters to the impeller. So during flow of air through the impeller, mechanical energy is imparted by the impeller to the air. Thus, it increases velocity V1 to V2 and pressure P1 to P2. In impeller section, then air is entering to the diffuser section. In diffuser, kinetic energy of air is converted into pressure energy. Thus, pressure increases from P2 to P02 and velocity decreases from P2 to V02 and air is discharged at outlet of centrifugal compressor. So here 50% pressure rise takes place in impeller and remaining 50% pressure rise takes place in diffuser section. So this was the about pressure and velocity variation of air in centrifugal compressor. Applications of centrifugal compressor. Here we can observe machine assembly line in automobile. So here pneumatic systems are used to operate the tools which are operated by using pressurized air of centrifugal compressor. In case of robot automation, we can observe here. This is the cylinder which is operated pneumatically. In case of thermal power plants, pressurized air of centrifugal compressor is used to operate powder handling system which is pneumatically operated. In case of automobile, turbochargers and superchargers are used to boost the power of engine. So it is done by using the pressurized air of the centrifugal compressor. Here we can observe, this is piston filling machine which is pneumatically operated by using pressurized air. In case of refrigeration and air conditioning systems, in chillers, centrifugal compressors are used to compress the vapor refrigerant from low pressure to high pressure. In manufacturing processes, here compressed air is used to operate the tools which are pneumatically operated. So at the end of this session, you can illustrate classification of centrifugal compressors. You can explain construction and working principle of centrifugal compressor, and you can explain applications of centrifugal compressor. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.